Welcome to the cancer tutorial for searching for patients. There are two primary areas in cancer in which you can search for patients. The first is the patient search in the top right-hand corner. This is by far the most commonly used feature for searching for patients. The second area is under patients and then search patients. We'll take a quick look at both. All right, so we'll start here in the search feature in the top right-hand corner. This is a very flexible search feature, meaning you can search in a wide variety of criteria. For example, you could do a partial name search. In this example with Jim Arthur, if we weren't sure if he went by James or Jim, we could search by J, Art, and it'll show us every patient with J and A-R-T in their name, right? So J in the first name, A-R-T in the last name, and then we can find our patient from there, okay? You can also search by nickname, phone number, serial number of the hearing instrument, email address, counselor ID number. It's overall very, very flexible. So you simply type in whatever you know, even if it's partial phone number, partial serial number of the hearing instrument, and it will search across the database and give you back anyone that it sees that matches that criteria. Okay, so the more general you have the search criteria, of course, the wider the search is going to be, and typically the more patients you'll see in the search results. The more specific, the fewer you'll see in the search results. Okay, now it's important to note when you do this search, as we saw there with J-A-R-T, there are additional ways to kind of run searches on top of this. So by default, counselor will search across clinics. So if you have multiple locations, this may come into play. If you have a single location, you wouldn't have to worry about this. But it'll automatically search across all clinics. You can drill down into individual locations if you wish. Now it's important to note that if you do a search for a patient and you don't see them on the list, one of the first things I would check would just to be make sure that you have this set to all clinics. That way you're not inadvertently excluding a patient that may be assigned to a different clinic. Right? It maybe says their preferred clinic. So that'd be the first thing. The second thing is, and this would affect anyone, whether you have one location or multiple locations, is to do a secondary search looking for inactive and deceased patients. Okay? You may have a secondary profile for this patient on purpose or on accident that you need to find. So you can do a search inactive deceased. It'll rerun the exact same search, and in this case, you can see it gave us one more search result. So there's a James Arthur in the system. Now, you can see right from here, if you tend to believe that this is a matching patient, right? So in this case, the date of birth is different, the phone number is different, so this appears to be a legitimately separate profile from Jim Arthur. But there are plenty of times when you'll see, hey, these match. Right? And there's a process in counselor where you can merge these profiles. But the point being is if you are run a search for a patient, you're not finding who you're looking for, double check to make sure you're set to all clinics, and then run a expanded search looking to include inactive and deceased patients. Okay? There's also an option here if you do need to search for multiple, you know, you do run a search for patients and you want to maybe check what's happening within their profile, but you want to keep this search available. There's an option here in the bottom left-hand corner to open records in a new window. And this will say, hey, keep this search open. And when I click on John Arthur, for example, it will then open up in a new tab within your browser, but keep this search available. Okay. And then if you want that gone, of course, you can go ahead and uncheck that. All right. The second option we mentioned for searching for patients is under patients and search patients. Now there's more specificity in this feature. So if you do need the ability to check, for example, show me all patients with a specific preferred provider that are of a certain status, right? You can get very specific in here. Of course, you have the same tools regarding, you know, searching by clinic, names, partial names, of course. You can search by date of birth, age range, with or without email address. So a lot of different tools in here. Patient tags, of course, a lot of different tools you can use to search. So you can have different combinations. You could say, show me all active patients by a certain preferred provider that do or do not have devices, let's say with hearing instruments, and also have a specific preferred physician. Right? You could run that search. It'll give you all the results. In this case, we have 31 patients that match that criteria. And then you could do what you need with that, right? Within the search results feature, whether we run it through the quick patient search here or under patients and then search patients, you have the ability. So it'll take you to the same place through either one of those search features, have the ability to under actions then, once again, you can rerun the search if you need to, though in this case you wouldn't need to. But you could download this, you can create letters or postcards, or you can send these patients an email. Okay? If you ever need to run a full patient search, one quick way is to, and this would be very, very uncommon, but if you ever needed to, you could do a search where you clicked into the quick search, don't put any criteria, click return, and it will show you the full patient list. Now, it's important to note that this ability may be restricted based upon your security settings. So if you do not have access to do an open patient search, it will likely limit the number of patients that you can see. So if you ever see your cap at, let's say, 100 patients, but you know you have more than that, that's related to your security settings. So you need to talk to an administrator within your clinic to see if they can run the search for you or if they want to open up your security settings to do so yourself. Okay. Of course, if you have any questions about how to search for patients in Counselor, please give us a call, email us, live chat us. We are always happy to help. Thank you very much for joining us for the Searching for a Patient tutorial.